These details provide for two-storey dwellings across the entirety of the site. All standard separation distances are achieved, both within the site and in relation to existing adjoining properties. Private amenity space and off-street parking provision for each dwelling is provided, including some garages. The layout, scale and appearance of the proposed development, together with the landscaping of the site, is considered to be acceptable and will not harm the character of the area or the amenities of neighbouring properties. Proposals are recommended for approval. Again, there's no petition or objection submitted with this application.
Mr. Ward, councillor. Can I open it up to committee?
Move approval, Chair.
Pat.
Sorry, just a quick question. There's the contribution from Wirral Wildlife that says tree protection measures should be implemented by conditions. I'm just wondering, are there conditions from the original that cover that? We're happy with that.
I move to approve, Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary. Thank you, Dave. All those in favour of approval? Against? That's carried. Thank you. We can move to agenda item 9, pages 69 to 74, INGLEBOROUGH ROAD, TRANMERE.
Sorry.
Yeah. Can we move to agenda item 11, which is Border Road Barnston? Matthew, can we have a presentation on that one, please?
Thank you, Chair. This application seeks permission for changes to a scheme approved in July last year. The amendments to the previously approved scheme include a new boundary wall with fence above, matching that at One Border Road, new entrance gates and the provision of a rear conservatory. The amended scheme also included the provision of a Juliet balcony, but this has subsequently been deleted from the scheme due to concerns relating to the potential for overlooking. The conservatory could also be built onto permitted development allowances once the dwelling has been built and occupied. Changes to the design of the conservatory have, however, been achieved, including the doors opening to the side onto the garden, which will reduce the overall impact of the conservatory. The remainder of the development is as approved last July. The amendments are considered acceptable and the application is recommended for approval. Again, there's no petition in relation to these proposals.
Do you have a word, councillor? Up to committee, please.
Move approval. Yeah.
Thank you, David.
Thank you.
Adi, seconded. All those in favour? Unanimous, that's carried. Okay, if we can move to agenda item 13, pages 95 to 110, North Wirral Brickworks, Carr.
Thank you, Chair. This application was the subject of a member's site visit on Tuesday. The application seeks permission to vary condition 28. On the 2013 appeal decision to allow details of a restoration and aftercare scheme to be agreed no later than the 31st of March 2016. The appeal decision required the submission of a restoration and aftercare scheme before the 31st of March 2015. The National Planning Policy Framework requires that restoration and aftercare should be carried out to high environmental standards. In November last year, the applicants entered into formal discussions with the Council in relation to the restoration and aftercare proposals, seeking to comply with Condition 28 of the Inspector's decision. Due to the need for significant environmental appraisals and ecological studies in relation to the restoration and aftercare proposals, and the requirement for consultation and advice from the Council's ecological advisers at MIAS, the timescales have slipped, which has resulted in the applicants technically being in breach of Condition 28, as a final agreed restoration and aftercare scheme has not yet been submitted. The applicants continue to work with the Council in this regard, and such a scheme is almost there, subject to further work around ecology. As such, the applicants have sought to extend the deadline by 12 months until the 31st of March 2016, although it is anticipated the final restoration and aftercare scheme will be submitted by the end of 2015. The restoration and aftercare schemes will provide for the final outcome, for the quarry once extraction and quarrying activities cease in 2042. The proposed extension in timescales, having regard to the significant work that has already been undertaken with regards to the final schemes, will enable the council and the applicants to continue working positively towards the content of a high quality and acceptable restoration scheme for the site. The proposal to extend the condition until the 31st of March 2016 does not change the environmental impacts associated with the permitted excavation of clay or the period over which they would be experienced. Quarrying of the site is permitted until 2042. The condition does require extraction and quarrying activities to cease until such time as a final scheme has been submitted. Although the applicants have submitted details as part of the formal discussions they've entered into with the local planning authority at the end of last year, a final and agreed scheme has not yet formally been submitted due to those ongoing discussions. Therefore, the winning and working of materials for the site are required to cease until such details have been submitted. It is our understanding that quarrying activities have temporarily been suspended in this regard, and as such, it is in the interests of the applicants to continue working proactively and quickly to progress a final restoration and aftercare scheme for submission in order to allow them to recommence their business activities. In conclusion, it is considered that an extension in time until the end of March 2016 is acceptable and will allow the main parties to continue working towards their final acceptable restoration and aftercare scheme. The application is recommended for approval. There is no petition in connection with this application.
Thank you, Matthew. So, Ward Councillor, can I put it up to committee? Paul?
Thanks, Chair. I noticed Matthew said the timescales have slipped. I just want to get to the roots of that, really. It looks as though the appeal was held in April 2013, is that right? And then the owners of this site, or the developers, seem to only have contacted the council last November in relation to submissions of these schemes. So is it their fault that these timetables have slipped because they didn't get in contact with us earlier?
Thank you through you, Chair. No, I wouldn't say it's the applicant's fault that timescales have slipped. I mean, obviously the condition required them to submit the final details before the 31st of March this year. They sought to do that at the end of last year, but for various reasons, we weren't prepared to accept the proposals that were presented to us. So we entered into formal pre-application discussions with the applicant to ensure that the final scheme that will be submitted is one that is acceptable to us at the local planning authority.
Any other comments? But the officer's recommendation is to approve this, subject to subject to the conditions,
yes, yes. Yes. Okay. We'll be picked up in the gate.
Thank you, whoever moved that. Do you have a seconder?
I'll second it, Chair.
Thank you, Steve. All those in favour? That's unanimous. That's sorry.
No.
I do apologise. Against? Thank you. That's carried. Thank you. Okay, we can move to agenda item 14, pages 111 to 118, which is Barnes Road Housing. Matthew, can you have a presentation, please?
Thank you, through you, Chair. Planning permission is sought for the replacement of existing garages. You can see them on this plan, there's three of them there. And the provision of a community shop together with temporary structures in adjoining land for recreation and visitors. The site sits in the Greenbelt, and as such they represent a departure from the development plan. An earlier approval in 2013 granted planning permission for the rebuilding of two of the garages together with an extension to form a community shop. This current proposal seeks to replace the existing buildings with a new building and also to use the adjoining land for outdoor seating and visitors' facilities. The site is close to access to the coastal path and the Wirral Way. The existing buildings are in a very poor state of repair, two of which are without roofs and detract from the visual amenities of the area. The replacement building will significantly improve the appearance of the area and will not result in any greater harm or impact on the openness of the Greenbelt. The community shop will serve the local community and visitors to the area. The National Planning Policy Framework supports sustainable rural enterprises and promotes the provision of local services, including shops. Conditions proposed, specifically conditions 9 and 10, give added controls to ensure the development cannot be used in ways that may not be in keeping with the Greenbelt. Restrictions on retail floor space and future extensions ensure the proposals will remain small scale and low key. The seating area and outdoor servery allow for further diversification and visitor attractions without detracting from the character of the area or the openness of the Greenbelt. The proposal for football and table tennis tables originally put forward and are no longer part of the development being proposed. The small-scale tourism and recreation elements of the scheme, together with the small-scale retail floor space, are considered to be acceptable and in accordance with policies GB2 and TL10 of the UDP, and that's in relation to the Greenbelt and tourism. Together with the provisions of the National Planning Policy Framework, the application is recommended for approval. There is no petition of objection in connection with this application. A non-qualifying petition of support signed by 21 signatures has been received, together with the 10 individual letters of objection.
Thank you, Matthew. Is there a board councillor? Can I move it up to committee? Thank you, David. I move approval of the seconder. Thank you, Matt. All those in favour of approval? That is unanimous. Thank you. That's carried. If we move to agenda item 15, pages 119 to 124, 83 Seacombe, Matt Lane, Peter.
This application seeks permission to convert an existing carriage building at the rear of 83 Seacombe, Matt Lane. So that's this square on your plan, to convert it into a self-contained dwelling. The building is currently used as a garage and an extension to that building is proposed. The resulting building will be a two-bed dwelling. The proposal is located at the rear of 83 Seacombe, Wallasey Lane and as such would not be visible from the street scene. Separation distances are all achieved, thereby ensuring that overlooking and loss of privacy is avoided. Adequate private amenity space is provided for the new dwelling and retained for the host dwelling at the front. Two off-street parking spaces are provided for the proposal, and also off-street parking is retained for number 83. The plans have been amended since they were originally submitted, principally to reduce any impact on 81A Seacombe Passing, which is this building here, which adjoins the property, which itself is a converted outbuilding now used as a self-contained dwelling. The application site is not within the Greenbelt, so objections relating to an increase in the footprint of the building do not apply in this instance, as that policy quoted in the objection relates to properties within the Greenbelt only. The site is located entirely within the primary residential area, where development such as this is permitted subject to policy HS4 of the Unitary Development Plan. As mentioned already, a similar development at 81 Seacombe Wallasey Lane has been permitted, and this proposal adjoins that approved development. The development proposed is acceptable in terms of its scale, form and layout, and complies with the criteria set out in Policy HS4 of the Unitary Development Plan. The application is recommended for approval. Again, there's no petition in connection with this application.
And again, I don't think we have a ward councillor, so open to committee. Any comments? No, the officer's recommendation is to approve subject to the conditions listed. Do we have a mover, please? Kathy, seconder? Matt, thank you. All those in favour of approval? That's unanimous. Carrie, thank you. If we can move to agenda item 16, pages 125 to 136. Proposed public consultation on the local listed building consent order for the residential housing. That are grade 2 listed. Reports on that.
Thank you, through you, Chair. This report sets out the local planning authority's intention to undertake public consultation on a local listed building consent order for grade 2 listed houses in Port Sunlight. Local listed building consent orders were introduced in 2013, which aimed to allow planning authorities to grant a general listed building consent for certain works on specified listed buildings. Such orders do not include demolition proposals. The aim of such orders is to grant consent for certain general works, such as replacement of windows and doors, which would ordinarily be subject to individual listed building consent applications. Provided such works complied with the provisions of the order, they would not need to come to the council for additional consent. The processes currently employed by the council will thereby be significantly streamlined and will allow homeowners to follow clear and reliable information to enable them to make minor alterations to their homes that would not harm the integrity of the listed building. The local planning authority is now seeking the agreement of the committee to engage with Portsmouth residents during a 5-week consultation to facilitate the adoption of this local listed building consent order.
Thank you. Are there any comments in relation to this?
I think we should support it. Thank you.
The officer's recommendation at 9.1 is to support it. All those in favour? So, sorry, can I have a mover, please? David, seconder?
Yes.
Joe? All those in favour? That's unanimous and carried. Agenda item 17, planning applications decided under delegated powers between the 10th of August and the 6th of September. Are there any comments in relation to that? Are we happy to note? Thank you. I haven't been made aware of any other urgent business, but can I remind everybody that there are site visit training at 2 p.m. on the 23rd of September, followed by additional training in committee room 2 at 5:30. Thank you for your attendance and your input.
Yeah.